Asian markets ended the week on a mixed note as investors looked ahead to the U.S. payroll report. Markets in Japan and China closed flat, while the South Korean KOSPI index rose 1.2%. Here at home, Philippine shares managed to extend their rally to a third straight day, with the main index posting its third weekly gain in four.
For the first week of June, the market has moved optimistically, or has moved positively, especially starting Wednesday. And this can be attributed to our inflation data. For me, even until now, the market is still focused primarily on the inflation and interest rate picture of the Philippines. It raises the possibility that the BSP will cut policy rates soon. And I believe this is one of the factors that has, that has boosted sentiment this week.
A notable stock movement in the region, shares of Toyota Motors slumped 1.6% Friday. That's after Bloomberg reported Japan's two biggest banks will start divesting their strategic shareholdings in the automaker, worth $8.5 billion. Saudi Arabia poised to raise more than $11.2 billion by selling shares in oil giant Aramco. Aramco shares were priced at $7.27 apiece. That's at the lower end of expectations. Sources say foreign demand was stronger than expected, especially from China and other Asian countries. Saudi Arabia has been seeking to lure international investment to pour tens of billions of dollars in projects to diversify away from its reliance on oil. Over in South Korea, Samsung workers make good on their threat to stage their first ever walkout in the tech giant's 55-year history. Members of the National Samsung Electronics Union held a protest outside the firm's office in Seoul Friday, holding signs calling for higher wages. The union did not say how many participated in the protest action, but the group represents roughly 28,000 employees, or that's a fifth of Samsung's workforce. Analysts say the walkout is unlikely to immediately impact semiconductor production or shipments, but it will add pressure on Samsung as it races to catch up in the AI race. Samsung shares closed in the red Friday, bucking the upswing in the broader Korean market. Let's check on European markets first. European markets are seeing losses after closing at record highs Thursday, following the European Central Bank's first rate cut in about 5 years. The DAX index is down 1% as the German Central Bank warned inflation is proving to be stubborn, reinforcing expectations that interest rates will come down slowly. As for Wall Street, futures are at the flat line ahead of the non-farm payroll report, with investors seeking confirmation of growing slackness in the U.S. labor market, which would give the Federal Reserve more leeway to cut interest rates this year.